Hi student, myself Shikri Vinod, working as an assistant professor in civil engineering department. Welcome again in the course of concrete technology. Today we see the properties of aggregate, what is the importance of aggregates in concrete, right? What are the mechanical properties of aggregate? And what are the classification of aggregate and different types of test done on aggregates. The main objective of studying aggregates in concrete technology course is to explain the importance of various properties of aggregates in manufacturing of concrete, get acquainted with some of the related technical terms in defining these properties of aggregates, like bulking of sand, saturated surface drag, condition of aggregate, flakiness and elongation index, fineness modulus of aggregate, and alkali aggregate reaction. Then the last objective is determining various properties in lab or at site. Now let's see the importance of aggregates. Aggregates are very important ingredient of concrete due to some reasons. They provide body and strength to the concrete. Role of aggregate is similar to that of bones in human body, means it gives skeleton to the concrete body with the help of aggregate, sand and other ingredients of concrete. Aggregates occupy about 75% volume of concrete and being comparatively cheaper as compared to the other ingredient. They govern economy of concrete. Not only the strength of concrete but also other properties are governed by aggregates, such as durability, workability, shrinkage volume and stability, etc. Then we will see properties of aggregates. Aggregates available for manufacturing of concrete can be broadly put under two categories, like natural aggregates and artificial aggregates. Natural aggregates are those which are available naturally. Example are sand in the riverbed or sea shore, or are manufactured from naturally available rocks, stones by manipulating their sizes, shapes and surface textures only, and other properties remain unchanged. And similarly, artificial aggregates are those which are manufactured artificially. Example, burnt clay, colored ceramic aggregates, or are obtained as byproduct or waste of industries like blast furnace slag. Now see, let's see the classification of aggregates based on the source, size, shape and weight. The aggregates are classified as the source of aggregates, size of aggregates, shape of aggregates and unit weight of aggregates. Let's see one by one. First, see source of aggregates. The classification of aggregate based on source of aggregate. Based on the source of material of natural aggregates, they are classified as igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks are formed due to volcanic eruption and cooling of magma by volcanic eruption of volcanoes. Sedimentary rocks are formed due to sedimentation. The sedimentary rocks takes long time for formation. Then metamorphic rock. The chemical and other properties of such aggregates are mainly governed by the properties of their pattern or parent rocks. Next classification is based on size of aggregates. Based on the size, aggregates can be classified as coarse aggregates and fine aggregates, or is also called sand. The aggregates of size greater than 4.75 millimeter are called as coarse aggregate and are available in 80 millimeter, 40 millimeter, 20 millimeter, 10 millimeter and 4.75 millimeter sizes. The fine aggregates are those which are having particles of size less than 4.75 millimeter. Depending upon the fineness modulus, the fine aggregates are categorized as coarse, medium and fine sand. Fineness modulus is most important property of aggregates. We will see in next lecture or in future. Then next classification of aggregate is based on shape. Shape of aggregates. Based on the shape, the aggregates are classified as rounded aggregates, angular aggregates, flaky and elongated aggregates. The rounded aggregates are without edges or corners and are smooth as compared to angular aggregates, which can be identified by their well-defined edges and corners. The surface area of rounded aggregates is comparatively smaller. Flaky aggregates is that whose least dimension, that is the thickness of aggregate, is reasonably small relative to other two dimensions, that is width and or length. Whereas elongated aggregate is that whose greatest dimension, that is length, is reasonably large relative to its mean dimension. Flaky and elongated aggregates are explained in detail further. Then aggregates are also classified on unit weight of aggregate. On the basis of unit weight, that is density, the aggregates are classified as normal weight, light weight and heavy weight aggregates. The criteria for classifying them into these categories, the aggregates are classified according to their unit weight in kilogram per meter cube, in which the normal weight aggregates has weight density 1522 1680 kilogram per meter cube. The example of normal weight aggregate is most of the natural aggregates. Then lightweight aggregates has density less than 1120 kilogram per meter cube. The example of lightweight aggregate is synthetic aggregates. Then heavyweight aggregates, the density of heavyweight aggregate is greater than 2080 kilogram per meter cube. The example of heavyweight aggregate is aggregates obtained from barium minerals, iron and titanium ores, etc. We see the density and specific gravity. These are the properties of aggregate, in which first bulk density. Density means mass per volume. The density of aggregate material and the density of aggregate sample are different in the sense that it depends as the weight of the sample of aggregates that would fill a unit volume in a standard manner. The sample of aggregates always has the volume occupied by voids and the solid aggregates. That is why the density of aggregate sample is designated as bulk density of aggregate. It depends on how densely the aggregates are packed, which further depend on the shape, size, grading and moisture content of the aggregates. So higher bulk density indicates lesser voids. The bulk density, in which the quantity of any material is more, and when we take sample in which the quantity of material is smaller due to self weight of the material, the density will be increased of any material due to quantity, and in sample the density is decreased due to self weight of the material. Then specific gravity. The specific gravity of an aggregate in its absolute sense is the ratio of the weight of the solid in a given volume of sample to the weight of an equal void free volume of water at the same temperature. Due to the presence of internal voids in aggregates, specific gravity of aggregate is more conveniently designated as apparent specific gravity. It is defined as ratio of the weight of the own dried aggregate to the weight of water occupying the volume of aggregates, including the volume of internal voids. It is determined in the lab by the formula, that is apparent specific gravity is equal to C divided by C minus B, where C is weight of aggregates dried in an oven at 100 to 110 degrees Celsius for 24 hours, and B for weight of saturated surface dry aggregate in water. With the help of formula, we can determine the specific gravity of the aggregate. Then saturated surface dry, that is SST condition of aggregate. Saturated surface dry condition means the aggregate is saturated and there is no water film on the surface of aggregate. The specific gravity based on the saturated surface dry condition is most frequently used in designing of concrete in concrete technology, because the water present in the internal pores of the aggregate does not contribute in the hydration process, so it can be considered as a part of the aggregate. Only surface dry or moisture free aggregates are considered. नेक्स्ट इज प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द सैंड इज बल्किंग ऑफ सैंड. द मॉइस्चर कंटेंट ऑफ एग्रीगेट इज ऑल्सो इक्वली इम्पोर्टेंट. द फाइन एग्रीगेट्स इन द डैम्प कंडीशन मे बी सब्जेक्टेड टू बल्किंग फिनोमिना. इंक्रीज इन वॉल्यूम ऑफ अ गिवन वेट ऑफ सैंड कॉज बाय द प्रेजेंस ऑफ मॉइस्चर इज टर्म एज बल्किंग. ड्यू टू द मॉइस्चर प्रेजेंट इन द सैंड द वन वन फिल्म विच विल बी फॉर्म विच रिपेल द सैंड पार्टिकल्स फ्रॉम ईच अदर ड्यू टू दैट द बल्किंग. इट मीन्स द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सैंड इज इंक्रीज. द प्रेजेंस ऑफ मॉइस्चर फॉर्म्स अ फिल्म ऑफ वाटर अराउंड द सैंड पार्टिकल्स ड्यू टू सरफेस टेंशन विच पुशेस द सैंड पार्टिकल्स अपार्ट एंड वॉल्यूम ऑफ सैंड इंक्रीजेस. द वॉल्यूम ऑफ सैंड गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग विद द इंक्रीज इन मॉइस्चर कंटेंट बट ओनली अप टू अ सर्टेन लिमिट दैट इज 5 to 6%. बियॉन्ड दिस द सर्फेस टेंशन रिड्यूसेस टू द एक्सटेंट दैट द वॉटर फिल्म इज डिस्ट्रॉयड. द सैंड पार्टिकल्स लूज द रिपल्सिव एक्शन एंड वॉल्यूम स्टार्ट रिड्यूसिंग. द बल्किंग फिनोमिना ऑफ फाइन एग्रीगेट इज एक्सप्लेन इन ग्राफ. ऑन हॉरिजेंटल और ऑन एक्स एक्सिस द मॉइस्चर कंटेंट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड एंड ऑन वाई एक्सिस द बल्किंग इज रिप्रेजेंटेड. द ग्राफ इंडिकेट्स दैट फाइनर सैंड बल्क्स कंसिडरेबली मोर एज कंपेयर टू कोर्स एंड मीडियम सैंड. द बल्किंग फिनोमिना इज ऑलमोस्ट अब्सेंट इन केस ऑफ कोर्स एग्रीगेट एज दे आर लार्जर इन साइज एंड हैवी इन वेट. बल्किंग इज ड्यू टू एडजॉर्प्शन ऑफ मॉइस्चर ऑन इंडिविजुअल सैंड पार्टिकल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ थिन फिल्म. द फिल्म ऑफ मॉइस्चर प्रोड्यूसेस सरफेस टेंशन विच कीप्स द सैंड पार्टिकल्स अवे फ्रॉम ईच अदर. दिस मेक्स द सैंड स्वेल एंड इट्स वॉल्यूम अपीयर्स मोर दैन द एक्चुअल वॉल्यूम ऑफ सैंड. If moisture content is increased, the bulking increase up to certain limit. After this limit, more moisture causes the film to break, and at saturation point, all the sand particles lose the film and sink into the water. So there is no bulking is observed. The range of bulking for the commonly available sand is from 15 to 30%. The bulking plays an important role in volume batching of fine aggregates for manufacturing of concrete. If the necessary correction to compensate the bulking is not made, such concrete mix will be under because the measured volume of bulk sand is greater than the actual volume of the sand. Therefore, the bulking of sand test will be done before any design of concrete. Today we saw the all the importance of aggregate, the classification according to size, shape and unit weight of aggregate. Then we see the specific properties in which the specific gravity of the aggregate, then the density of aggregate and bulking of sand is seen in this lecture. In next lecture, we see soundness of aggregate, the alkali aggregate reaction, then different index related with aggregate properties like flatness index and elongation index. Then after that we will see the sieve analysis, fineness models and grading of aggregate done in the lab. According to that we will specify the different sizes of aggregate. Then mechanical properties of aggregate like aggregate crushing value, aggregate impact value and aggregate abrasion value we will see in next lecture. Thank you.